My name is Tim Walking Bear Goodblood. I have worked with plants and nature my whole life. I have specialized in herbalism, the teaching of it and the application of it in my life and other people's lives for the past 17 years. I work with plants, help plants communicate, and I help people to open their wild hearts and to rekindle their inherent connection to nature and the earth.
I am the Plant Whisperer.
Well, I'm sitting here in my back room having my coffee, waiting for the sun to come up. The horizon is lightening, and in about a half hour the sun's going to come across the horizon. The birds just started to sing to greet the morning sun, as they do every morning. Once the sun caresses the horizon, all the ravens will go off and they'll start singing simultaneously to let us all know the morning is here. Anyway, I'm just sitting here doing my morning wake up, contemplating the mysteries of life. And I've been thinking about the herbalism and plant communication. I've been working with plants for a long time, pushing 20 years now. And when I think back on when I first started this journey with the plants, I was very green in my teachings. And I was running around the forest with my field guide on plants and trying to find the different plants and teach myself about herbalism. At the same time period, I was also learning from my spiritual elders, my native elders. So I was very green in those teachings as well. And my actions and mannerisms and way of doing things kind of was the same with the spirituality as it was with the herbalism. I had a strong passion for wanting to learn. And in my zealous attitude, sometimes I was overbearing and pushy and jumped the gun and made a lot of mistakes along the way. And I learned from those mistakes. But when I think about plant communication, early on, I could see myself running through the forest with my Peterson's field guide for wild medicinal plants in my hand. And I'd have one or two herbs marked out in that book. And I'd be looking for them. I'm on the hunt. I'm tracking down these two plants. And all the while, I'm going by thousands of plants that are reaching out to me constantly. And I got blinders on. I'm looking for those one plant or the two plants or the few plants that I've narrowed down in the book that I want to find. What an arrogant little prick I was. And then I do find the plant and I approach it. And what do? I got the book in my hand, and I look down at the plant, and I say, "Hey, plant, this book here says you're good at healing cuts, bruises, and abrasions, and that if I crush your leaves and put it on my a bleeding wound, it'll stop my wound from bleeding." Is that right, plant? Teach me about yourself. Now, of course, the plant's sitting there going, "Yeah, I can do all those things. But hey, look at that pine tree over there. Look at this wintergreen next to me. Hey, we got a community here, man. There's a whole bunch of us here. You got to talk to all of us." But I'm not listening to that. I'm not even hearing anything the plant's saying because I'm too much in my head and in the book. But that's how you learn. That's how you get from one place to another. You experience. You take action. You interact. Sometimes you fall flat on your face and make mistakes. Pick yourself up, brush yourself off, evaluate your situation, and strive on and try to do it a little differently next time around. And you learn and you grow. Over time, over years and years of communing with nature, studying, harvesting plants, making medicine with them, working with them, using them in my body, paying close attention to my body and what these chemicals and plants do within my body and within other people's bodies, and also paying very close attention and journaling and taking note of all the changes within the natural world around me and the unnatural world, but specifically the natural world. And it's no great gift to hear the communications of nature. It's just a matter of being observant and listening. How arrogant I was to approach an elder of the plant kingdom in the way I did in my early days. But I approached my human elders in the same way in my ignorance. But they were loving and understanding. And, you know, I'd go to an elder, native elder, with a gift of tobacco in the traditional way, or blanket, or some other gift. But I present them with a gift. I ask them a question. Now the elder accepts the gift and will answer my question, but maybe not right then and there. I might have to hang out with them for 2 or 3 days, maybe even a year. Some subjects has taken years before I've gotten answers. But that is the way. They are the elders. They've lived and experienced. They have wisdom to teach us. And it's not just the wisdom that we're seeking that they have to teach us. They have their own agenda of what they need to teach in their life to other people. So if I have to sit and learn how to split wood and hang grandmother's laundry for 2 days before I get my answers that I have been seeking, well, then maybe that's what I need to learn from her. She needs to teach me how to do the laundry before she will answer my question about a medicine or about a custom or a culture. I will afford her the respect of allowing her the time that she needs to be in a place where she needs to be to answer my question. Because she wants to give me the best that she can. So she's not going to give me it right off the bat. She's going to wait until it's the right time. Grandfathers and grandmothers in my native culture, this has been my experience with them. So the protocol is respect and honor. Approach with respect, request, make your answer, ask your question, and be patient. The elder will deliver one way or another, even if it's not an answer. No answer may be your answer. So, if I would afford a two-legged of my own people the respect of this protocol when wanting to approach them, to learn from them, why wouldn't I afford another creature the same respect and the same honor, especially if it is of another kingdom, another nation? I mean, when you think about this, If the President of the United States goes to the UN, he's addressing other nations. There's a certain protocol that he has to follow to be heard in the United Nations. Same thing is true among smaller communities of people, like the Rustic Band of Mi'kmaq, a small band of the Mi'kmaq Nation. Same kind of thing is true. There's a certain protocol people follow within the community to be heard and to receive answers. The same is true in the plant world. When I walk out into the forest and address the forest and ask the plants to guide me and teach me, I may have one plant in mind, but I'm addressing the whole UN of the forest. UN, I like that. Instead of United Nations, we got United Nature. But now I'm a two-legged ambassador going to the standing trees and plants kingdom and asking them for advice and guidance. I have to treat that with great respect and honor and protocol, just as if I were sitting before the United States Congress or any other body of high elders. If I were addressing the Mi'kmaq Nation Grand Council, I would treat them with the same kind of protocol and respect.